Well, hello guys. This is Hanging In and Out of St. Louis with Eldora. I am over here at the St. Louis Armory or Armory STL or STL Armory. I'm on one of the parking lots that they have. So this is the parking lot. These are probably going to be mini videos. This parking lot is on Market and Prospect, and how I got to the parking lot was off of Vandeventer. So you take Forest Park, was that Boulevard, to Vandeventer, to South Vandeventer or Vandeventer South, and then you're gonna drive it, and then you'll see the sign that says Market. Market is one street past the street that says Foundry. Be careful trying to make that left turn at that area to try to get on the Market. Drive it down the Prospect to Market, and then the street to say Prospect, and then you make that right turn and make the left turn onto the lot. Get out this car's way. So I'm walking over, waiting. There's an Uber. You can catch Uber over here or the share ride over here. And so you can't go any further. That's the parking lot. This is the building. If you want to find out more about the Armory, you can go on their website, STL Armory, and it'll tell you about the history of the building. I'm just letting you see the street sign. I believe this is the Forest Park Expressway right here that's running past. So this is a side road, and right there you see the sign that says pick up. So you stand there if you want to do the share ride with like Uber or one of those share ride companies. What is it? Lyft is another one. So there you go. Okay, so I'm gonna go, instead of going through the front of the building where the shared ride is, I'm gonna come over here, walk back over here to the side. So this is part one on how to get to the St. Louis Armory. And I'm going to end this video, and then once we get inside, I'll look and see what we can film. Okay, I guess I should have gotten this. I took a picture of it, but this is the information to have for the St. Louis Armory. We're going through the door. I'm beginning to think my finger is the signature mark for me. Okay, so they're still doing construction with this. I guess we... This is cute. All right, we're gonna take the stairwell. Okay, and then I guess this is where you pay to get in. Tickets are, depending on the time of day or the time of week, tickets are, admission is from free, $5, $7, $10. And then I don't know how much the concerts cost. After 8 p.m. to 12 and 1 p.m. Okay, guys, I paid my admission. I had to use a credit or debit card. She said for this event, they did not take cash. So I had to use my debit or credit card. But this is it. Look like you just run up to a table that's a game table that's free and they start playing. Guess you can see some. They're playing some type of knockdown game. You on my channel, I guess. Okay, so I guess I can just run over and pick up the stick and start playing putt-putt. Got some upstairs seating. Looks like it's a sports game on. It is. Try to walk through this as quick as possible. There go a slide. This is after 6 p.m. On Saturdays and Sundays, this becomes an event for people who are age 21 and over. On Saturdays between 11 and 5, the child has to be accompanied with an adult. Monday through Friday is from 4 p.m. And closes at 12. Saturday, 11, and closes at 1 p.m. Sunday is open at 11, and I think closes at 1 p.m. But no children are allowed in here after 6 p.m. on the weekends. And no children are allowed in here Monday through Friday from 4 p.m. to 12 p.m. So this is basically for adult. It's adult entertainment in an adult entertainment center. But don't take my word for it, because you know I told you. Always, when it comes to me, always go to the internet and read and do your own research so that you can get the best and update information and the truth. So this is a food area. So you go upstairs and ride the slide down. Thank you. So you stand in these lines and order your food. I don't think you would sing. So it looks like it's two seesaws in here. Some here, I think it's around 4 p.m. So that's why you're seeing the kiddos. They'll be getting kicked out by 6 p.m. I don't know if you have to pay for these. So yeah, that's $1. shut it down for your private party. You can go online and find out how to make that happen. And then if it's 49 people and under, you just come in. Bring your party. No balloons, because they said they didn't want the balloons to get trapped up in the ceiling. They can't get them down. So no helium balloons. They tell you you can't bring any drinks in here because they want you. But it's a business. They want you to buy. They're playing bean bag toss. They got lots of bars. More seats. Another bar. Some more gaming, some more games for you gamers. Latrines, bathrooms, toilets, depending on what country you're in. Restrooms, depending on your culture. You come here and watch the game. I don't know how current it is. I don't know what this is. Nice. And then we're back in the front. Hi! There's some more chairs. You can sit here and watch the game. So this place is open every day. Monday through Sunday. As far as I can see, it's a nice, something nice for St. Louis to have, especially since we have some cold, icy winters. This is a nice place to hang out. Winter, spring, summer, or fall. You can come by yourself or come in with your friends and just, it's a social gathering. I like this. What do you think? I like this, and I'm glad that something like this has been brought to the St. Louis, Missouri area. It's needed. Okay, have a good day.